You might find it difficult, but there is the joy. There is a have an option. We want to sell our time to you. The painting is a shelf built for the painting. This man's son. And this man's son died in the wrong place. And we have built on a range of love about his son. So we have built on a range of love. So, what do you want for the painting? And no one will put it on.
Have words. Scientists have words for us. is of God, here is God's word. Says he. He that is of God, hears God's word. If you're of God, if you want to love God, then you'll hear God's word. It says, he that is of God, hears God's word. You therefore hear them not, because you are not of God. If you are of God, and you love God, then you'll hear His word. You'll listen to His word. You'll honor His word. You'll lift up His word. The devil wanted to attack the word of God. The devil said to Eve, the devil said to Eve, did God say? And the devil was putting down on the word of God. When the devil came to Jesus in the desert, he said, if thou be the Son of God, and Jesus said, man cannot live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And we need the word of God in our lives. Did you know that William Tyndale translated the Bible in English? William Tyndale translated the Bible in English so that we could read the Bible in English, and he lost his life when he did that. They killed him. They killed him, my friends. They killed him for translating the Bible in English. All because the Bible was translated in English. So you have the word of God in English so that you can read it and know that it is the word of God. If a man keep my saying, he shall never taste of death. If a man keep my saying, he shall never taste of death. What he's saying there is that if we obey the word of God and believe in it, when we die, there is no sting in death. Paul said, death, where is thy sting? And one day you and I will die. One day. And when we die, death will have a sting. Death will take us down. But if we believe in Jesus Christ, death has no power over us. We will rise again and be with Jesus. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. And he promised that if you believe in him, you will rise again. And you will be with him forever. That's why he said, I am the resurrection and the life.
Good
basically, you'd like to stop. It says, in John chapter 16, verse 10, have righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more. The Holy Spirit of God comes. The Holy Spirit of God comes and shows us the righteousness of God. The Holy Spirit comes and shows us the righteousness of God. And God is a righteous God. That God cannot turn a blind eye to what we do. God cannot turn a blind eye to the things that you do wrong and I do wrong. If I do wrong and you do wrong, God cannot turn a blind eye. He's a righteous God. And as a righteous God, he has the right and the desire and the character to judge the world. That's why he's a righteous God. He is going to counterbalance the world. He's going to judge the world, and it's going to be balanced out on judgment day. That's why he's a righteous God. He's a righteous God. And as a righteous God, he has to judge. And he has to deal with you and me. He has to deal in judgment, and he has the right to judge, for he is a righteous God. me. The wickedness of my heart and the wickedness of your heart. Any wicked thing that you have ever done or I have done, he died on that cross for you. He paid the price on that cross for you. That is the righteousness of God. That is the righteousness of God. There he paid that debt on that cross for you. He paid that debt for you on that cross. He says in the word of God, you should not lie. He says in the word of God, you should not steal. He says in the word of God, thou shalt not commit adultery. He says in the word of God, honor your father and mother. Says in the word of God, honor the Sabbath day. Says in the word of God, do not have any idols. Says in the word of God, do not use God's name in vain. And if you use God's name in vain, if you have an idol above God, if you look or do anything and commit adultery or in your mind or in your heart, if you lie or if you steal, then we all under the judgment of God. And God's holiness and God's purity cannot look upon our sin. He cannot look upon it. But in his magnificent love and in his wonderful love for you and me, in his wonderful love for you and me, in his great love for you and me, he came and went to that cross and lovingly died on that cross for you. He lovingly died on that cross for you. There's a story of a guy who was a millionaire. This millionaire died. And all the people came to the house for the money. They wanted the money. And inherited the money from this millionaire. So they came to the house. And they were expecting to get all the money. And the money be left there. And as they were there, the solicitor said, before we give out the money, we have a picture to sell, to auction. So they auctioned this picture. And it was a picture of a boy. And the picture was scruffy. But the scruffy picture was the son of the millionaire. And this scruffy picture was the son of the millionaire. And The only way is to know Jesus Christ. The only way is to know the Son of God. He is reality. He is the reality of love. He is the reality of salvation. He is the reality of all that God is. For he says, I am the Father thou art. And when you see Christ, you see the Father. And Christ came to die for you on that cross. He came to set you free, to liberate you from your bad habits, to liberate you from the things that are pulling you down, to liberate you and set you free, to bring you into the kingdom of his love and into the kingdom of God. That's why he died for you. He died to set you free. But if your hopes are drugs, or if your hopes are porn, or if your hopes are alcohol, or if your hopes are materialism, or if your hopes are and you're selfish, and your hopes are that, and that's what you want, that you're dying, but Christ has come to set you free. He's come to set you free.
That joy is in Jesus Christ.
Christ. That joy can liberate you and set you free in the midst of your difficulty, in the midst of your worry and pain. Jesus can set you free. He can give you a hope and a peace and a joy and a comfort that nothing else can do. Drugs cannot help you. Then you take drugs. And for that one day, when you take drugs, you're knocked out for that one day. And you get rid of your problems for one day. But the next day, the problems come back. You don't get rid of the problems. You can get drunk. And when you get drunk, it gets rid of the problems for one night.
I have brought us good.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.